Right. Let's look at the UPND-led administration. It's been it's now 3 months since the UPND Alliance was elected into office. What would be your assessment of the new Dawn administration so far?
You know, I would like to be charitable to the UPND. You know, so this is not my assessment. Mm-hmm. This is my observation on account of what they themselves said. So, to be fair to the UPND, you ought to do what you are referring to as assessment against what they said. Mm-hmm. What did the UPND say? What have they done now? And I've segmented this into short term, medium term, and long term. And the Zambian people voted PF out, voted UPND in on account of the campaign promises that the UPND, you know, gave to the Zambian people. What has happened in the last 3 months is that not a single campaign promise by UPND has been fulfilled. Not even a single one has been fulfilled. Let me start with the immediate ones. Mm-hmm. President Hakainde Hichilema, during his campaign, was very emphatic as to the economic problems of our country, especially the rate of the kwacha to the dollar. And this is what he said. He said, mark my words, to paraphrase, he said, the day I'm sewn in at 10 hours, by midday or thereabouts, the kwacha would have come down to 10 kwacha to a dollar. And you know what he said also? Because the international community has confidence in the UPND. He got sworn in. He's been sworn in after 3 months now. PF left the dollar at 15 kwacha to a dollar. Left the kwacha at 15 to a dollar. It is now almost, by this Friday, I'm sure by tomorrow, it may hit 18 kwacha to a dollar. Okay? UPND said the problem that we have with our economy is that the fuel prices are very high. And they are high because PF has allowed this group of middlemen in the importation of oil. We are going to remove the middlemen and ensure that fuel prices drop. There is a story now, you know, in News Diggers today, which says fuel prices and electricity tariffs need to be increased to avert future challenges. This is from the Bank of Zambia. This is from the Bank of Zambia governor, whom Mr. Hichilema told us, I'm going to give you the best bank governor in the world so far. He brought back Den Kariaria. And this is from Bank of Zambia. So he lied about the kwacha dollar rate. He lied about the issue of reducing fuel, the pump price of fuel. He has lied, you know, about ZESCO tariffs. And what Bank of Zambia is saying in this article is what the IMF have told them. Not that they have thought about it. These are conditionalities from the IMF. Now, if he had said to the Zambian people, if he had said to the Zambian people that I have no capacity to improve the kwacha dollar rate, if he had said to the Zambian people, I have no capacity to, you know, I'm not going to reduce the pump price of fuel. If he had said to the Zambian people that, when I get into office, I'm going to increase
electricity tariffs, they wouldn't have voted for UPND. The Zambian people would not have voted for UPND. They voted for UPND because the man lied to this nation.
Don't you think he needs more time to sort all those things out?
No.
Don't you think 3 months, let's just say 100 days now, is a bit too short to sort out all those problems you've highlighted?
Let's not get into, this American culture, 100 days, and that kind of thing. You know, if a man projects his word as his bond, hold him to it. Why are you giving him? The man didn't say the Kwacha will come down within 100 days. He said the Kwacha will come down, the rate will come down the same day. So why are you giving him 100 days? The man didn't say ZESCO tariffs will be reduced in. He said, I will not. No, he didn't say will be increased in 100 days. He said, I'm going to reduce the tariffs. Now, how long does it take the UPND government, or how long should it take the UPND government to reduce the tariffs on electricity? It shouldn't take more than a week. They are in government. ZESCO is a parastato. ERB is a parastato. So we don't see the reason why this has not been done. And in fact, not only done, even catapulting now, changing the statement that this economy is in problems because ZESCO tariffs are low. That this economy is in its doldrums because the fuel pump price is low. Isn't that what they criticized the PF about? That was their major weapon against the PF. And they ride on those lies and they do nothing. And they want to even do the opposite. And you want to give them 100 days. 100 days to do what? They must honor their word.
I want to also pick your thoughts on this one. Upon assuming office, President Hakainde Hichilema told the world that his government inherited empty coffers and that corruption was more deep-rooted than was thought. However, up to now, we haven't seen any conviction on corruption. While the president has continued to, with his international trips, was the president being sincere when he made this statement?
Well, if what I've said is anything to go by, he has never been sincere over anything. He has never been sincere over anything. He's jumped on this Titanic ship of lies to the Zambian people. Okay? That's what he has done. He has never been sincere about anything so far. Okay? Now, he's talking about empty coffers. He's talking about corruption. These turn out to be a figment of his own imagination because nothing has been proven so far. There is no PF former minister who has run away from this country. Edgar Lungu is around. All his former ministers are around. All his former PSCs are around. Nobody has jumped the border to run away from the alleged corruption. Should it take 90 days, 100 days to show us that the PF government was grossly corrupt? No. Again, they psyched the Zambian people over this corruption mantra during their campaigns. And the Zambian people believed them. In fact, he used to say, I have, sources from within PF. I'm well connected. So what I'm telling you is the truth. Tell us, prove the truth now. And the only truth that we have seen from the man is to jump on the Challenger and going round. He was at the UN General Assembly. Okay? He met the World Bank managing director there. He met officials from the IMF. What in God's name have those meetings realized for the Zambian people? Zero. Zero to date. So, then you come up with this mantra of new donor administration. We saw this under Chiluba. New culture.
The MMD, when they came into power, they came up with this mantra of new culture. New culture. Mana, it only went on for 6 months to a year. When they realized that governance was difficult, they abandoned the mantra of new culture. And we'll see the same thing happen with the UPND. In the next 3-4 months, none of the ministers reading a boring speech will ever refer to this government as a new dawn government. Could it be? Because there will be no dawn, you know, to talk about. It will all be darkness. It will all be failure.